concerns. I don't know about you.
I think he did really well on this one, Joe. I think maybe we should talk about it a little bit. What do you think?
Yeah, you might maybe walk around and maybe sit down and have a chat and just take a walk down by the water.
The girls definitely have plenty of room to run and play.
Yeah, we'd be giving them a lot of water and a lot of water to learn to love. Looks like he's got some pretty good depth here, too. You get a nice side boat in there someday.
Ryan, I think we have to really think about this house.
Let's sit down for a second and talk about everything we've seen, okay?
Okay.
So,
I really have a good feeling about the Island View house. I think this house is amazing, and I think it offers everything that we've had on our wish list.
They all have great attributes. We started out with the South Bay house.
That was a cute house. I really liked the girl feel of that home.
I like pulling up and being able to see right out from the side into the back, and that beach area, and the lawn space, that appeals to me in many ways.
The bedrooms were a little bit small, but I did like the deck space and the extra room that I had in the off-season that we could use.
The Oyster Bay house, what are your thoughts there?
It didn't have a lot of play space for the girls.
$800,000 was, in my mind, significantly over the budget. I think for our needs, that's not going to suit us. Let's take that one off the list right away.
Okay.
Then the last two, I'm kind of impressed with both of them.
But I don't know. This is a beautiful main street. No sense of community here. This is a lot of things on our list.
It does. I'm hesitant over a few things. The pool we have to maintain, the bulkhead, it has way more than we hoped for. He hit the nail on the head with the price point at $750, but the four games, that's really dated. I don't know if it's really within our budget if we start considering the renovations and the constant maintenance on a house on the water.